Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of my two-part tutorial showing how to make a vintage 1960s psychedelic music poster. Picking up from part one, we're ready to add the text. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a psychedelic style font. I'm using Bell Bottom Laser. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. Make the point size relatively small to medium. We'll adjust the size later with the Transform tool, which will allow us to quickly and accurately modify the size of each word. Make the anti-aliasing sharp and click the right alignment icon. For now, make the color white. If it's not white, just click on it to open the color picker and pick white. Click on the upper right of your document and type out your first word. Click your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Place your cursor inside the Transform and drag the word near the inside corner of your poster. Go to the bottom left corner of your Transform, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Shift as you drag it out until the first character is slightly overlapping the edge of your subject. Then press Enter or Return. Press the T key on your keyboard to open your Type tool and click below the text. Type your second word, click your Move tool, and open your Transform tool. Drag it up and over so it's flush with the right edge of the text above it. If you want, you can opt not to use the Shift key so your text will stretch or compress as you drag the Transform. Or you can press and hold the Shift key to retain its aspect ratio. Then press Enter or Return. Continue to fill the right side of your document with text. Go to your Layers panel and scroll down to the bottom text layer. Shift-click on it to make it and the rest of the text active. Go to Type and Rasterize Type Layer. Rasterizing it instantly changed the text to image files, which allows us to ultimately warp them just like any picture. Click the thumbnail of the bottom text to make just this layer active. Open your Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. By manipulating the points and lines, we can warp the first character to closely mirror the subject's curve. If you want, you can also warp any other part as well. Then press Enter or Return. Warp the first character of each word so the entire block of text is nestled against the subject. We're going to convert all the text layers into a smart object so we can warp all the text as one shape. In addition, smart objects allow us to make changes to the text if we want to without having to redo all the effects we'll be adding to it. Make the top layer active, scroll down to the bottom text layer, and shift-click on it to highlight all the text layers. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel, and click Convert to Smart Object. You know it's a smart object if you see this icon on the thumbnail. Open your Transform tool, click the Warp Transform icon, and drag the points up and down to warp the entire block of text into one undulating shape. Make sure the first characters of each word remain nestled next to the corresponding shape of the subject. Also, make sure the top, bottom, and right side of the text stay in place. Then, press Enter or Return. Let's name the layer Write Text. Next, we'll create the text on the left side of the poster. Go near the top left and press the T key to open your Type tool. Click on your document, click the left alignment icon, and type your first word. As before, click your Move tool and open your Transform tool. Drag it up and over and expand it out until it slightly overlaps the edge of the subject. Then, press Enter or Return. Continue to add text so it fills the entire left side of the poster. Warp each word individually so its last character mirrors the shape of the subject next to it. Using the same steps as you did earlier, convert all the text into one smart object. Let's name it Left Text. As you did earlier, warp the entire block of text. Next, we'll add gradient color, outlines, and strokes to all the words. First, we'll place the left and right text layers into a folder. To do this, shift-click on the thumbnail of the right text layer to highlight both layers, and then press Ctrl or Command G. Let's name it Text. Click the adjustment layer icon and choose Gradient. Make the style linear and the angle 90 degrees. Click the gradient bar and click the Spectrum preset thumbnail. Then, click OK on both windows. Right now, the adjustment layer is affecting all the layers below it in the Layers panel. To clip it or restrict it to just the text, go to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. Click the Text folder to make it active, and click the FX icon. Choose Stroke. Click the color box and pick white, then click OK. I'll make the size 10 pixels, but keep in mind, if your document has a different size and resolution, you may want to adjust the amounts for your image that I'm using in the layer styles. Click Outer Glow and the color box. Pick a color. I'll pick orange. Change the blend mode to normal and make the opacity 100%. Make the spread 100% and I'll make the size 20 pixels. Scroll to the top and make the paper texture visible and active. Change the blend mode to multiply. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.